Hey, this is Swedish Guitar Nerd, and today I'm gonna demo a Jackson guitar. That's the first for me. And for a change, it's not the super cheapest guitar you can find in the guitar store. It's actually a more expensive guitar. It is a Jackson Pro Dominion. It's the Mark Morton of Lamb of God's signature guitar. And this is the original version. Made in Japan. So yeah, things have changed over the years. I think they're made in Indonesia at the moment, and some of the specs have changed. I'll try to comment on them as I go. So let's start at the top. And on this model you get US made Spurzel locking tuners. So that's something you can spend money on. It probably costs more than most guitars, just the tuners. So that's a nice touch. And needless to say, they work fantastic. It's a neck through body design. So it's there's nothing here, and it goes all the way down here. I think they're using a scarf joint, at least on the newer models they do. But from here to here, it's the same thing. It's a three-piece neck, as I understand it, and it has graphite reinforcements. And again, as I understand it, they go from here to here. And I don't know, if you have this kind of headstock, no volute as usual, of course, they never do that. Why not have the graphite rods go all the way up here, or for that matter, all the way from here down to here? And you have a neck through body design. Well, they're supposed to help stability. And probably they do. This is a mahogany neck, so it certainly needs help. It's a very slim neck. For being, I mean, this is of course a Les Paul copy, even though it has this rather odd shape. It actually was a Jackson model that had a similar shape before this one, so it's not completely made up by Mr. Morton, but it's very unusual, and it's, yeah, it's his all right. As I said, we have a mahogany, three-piece mahogany neck, and we have a ebony fingerboard. And it has the, as usual in most, almost every these days, Jackson guitar, it has a compound radius. It starts at 12 inch and ends at 16 inches. So it's flat and even flatter. And it's supposed to up here help you with, I don't know, playing chords, and down here to make it easy to play really fast. And fast it plays. They have started, I mean, Jackson is a Fender company these days, and they have started doing this on Fender guitars as well. The at the moment the elite Fender guitars have this, and to my experience the Fender ones aren't really doing it right, which is rather strange, because I don't know, same company, they should be doing it the same way, because here it works. It's, yeah, everything is where it's supposed to be. If you look at a Fender Elite guitar the next time you go into a guitar store, and check the frets down here, all the guitars, the Elite guitars I've ever looked at, every single one has had, like, the middle of the fret isn't connected to the fretboard. So they are probably using frets that are radiused to fit up here, and then just install them here. And they are rounder, so they're not flat against the fretboard. That's my experience. Every single one. I've checked Fender Elite guitars in several stores in several countries. They all look the same. So maybe you have another experience. But this works. And well, when we get down to the body, we have All pro gear here. It's very well made, solid stuff. Everything, the electronics is really high grade. The bridge is made by Schaller, a German company, famous for making, for instance, the original Floyd Rose. They are the only ones that can make the original and have it say original today. We have US made Seymour Duncan 59 pickups, which I'm using in other guitars at the moment. I really like them. And we have coil splits for them, individual ones. The finish of this one is a limited one. It was these years, this is from the late 2000s, 2006, 7 somewhere, called Primer, and it's flat black, all right. And the flaws of this guitar, well, even though it's made in Japan and a Pro Series one, so it's like the high grade ones. They have painted over the sides of the fretboard, and they painted over the sides of the nut, a graphite nut. And with temperature and humidity, they have, I mean, the neck, yeah, it's wood, so it moves. And yeah, at least the final layers of paint are starting to crack, or have cracked already at the fret ends and around the nut. Doesn't look very tidy, but that's about it. That's all the faults I could find. So I'm gonna play some for you, and I'm gonna start with a clean sound and with the pickups split. So it'll be single coil sounds out of these humbuckers, if you can hear what that sounds like. Yeah, here we go. Yeah, and now I'll put him in full humbucker mode. Still a clean sound. Thank you. Okay, some overdrive, and I'll maybe flick the switches a bit, but it'll be a full humbucker most of the time. You can see me reaching for the wrong switch there, and it's kind of strange and perfect. You can see the controls aren't where you usually find them on a Les Paul, much closer to the bridge, so easy accessible. And the thing is, they are reversed compared to what you're used to. So these are the ones for the bridge pickup, and these are the ones for the neck pickup, which makes a lot of sense to me. So I like this. But still unusual. And I'm still unused to it. Okay, let's try some high gain.
Thank you.
So there you have it, the Jackson Dominion Pro. And yeah, this guitar had been hanging on the wall of the guitar store where I bought it for 10 years almost. So I got it at a crazy sale price, but I wonder why didn't people buy it? Because it has all these super pro features. I mean, upgraded hardware, it's super American made, German made, American pickups, guitar is made in Japan. I don't know. Leave a comment. Why do you think people don't buy this guitar? Because it's still in the Jackson range, so apparently it sells somewhere. I don't know. And it's a great guitar. I couldn't resist it. I really couldn't. And I love it. I play it live now. So yeah, I recommend this if you had the money. And I think I prefer this version to the new one. Especially this one that has no inlays, because this is a very rare model. The new one has Jackson branded tuners, still locking, but not as fine, probably. It has the DiMarzio pickups, his new DiMarzio pickups that are based on Steve Vai's Breed pickups, which I think are ceramic. And they're probably good as well. These are Alnico 2s, 59s. So, yeah. And they have the Tone Pros bridge on the new one. That's probably an upgrade to this one, even though this is Schaller German quality. Well, this has been the Swedish Guitar Nerd reviewing a Jackson guitar. Hope you found this useful. See you soon.